Hi viewer, I welcome you to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies form 2. To lesson number 11, the topic it is warehousing. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson objectives. We are going to look at the meaning and the importance of warehousing to the business. The meaning and the importance of warehousing to the business. Introduction. When I talk about a warehouse is a place or building where goods are stored until their demand arises. For example, you can be able to see we have a number of goods that are stored in that building where we have our warehouse. They are stored there until their demand arises. On the other hand, warehousing is the process of storing goods until the time they are required. You can also say that I store a certain good until it is required. You store maize in the store until it is required for it to be consumed. You go and get the wholesalers. They will store the goods in a store until their demand arises. So that is a warehouse where they are storing these goods. Now, when I talk about the warehousing itself, it creates time utility. Time utility means it's time for it to be consumed, a time for it to be used is ready or it has reached. You keep until you get the time utility. What is the importance of warehousing to the business? One, there is the steady flow of goods. For example, if you look at your right hand side, you are going to get that we have a storage of flour. And when you look at this flour, it is not one or two or even three. Then it means that there will be that steady flow, even if that commodity is not produced for the next 2 months, for the next 1 month, then its supply it is steady. Number two, stability in prices. So there is nothing like a commodity is not being produced and we start hiking the prices. So that is the purpose of warehousing, keeping these goods in a store. You keep them in a store, the time when they are not available, they serve that purpose. So it ensures that during that period when they are not available, their prices are not going to hike. Number three, protection of goods. They protect goods from getting damaged. Number four, meeting unexpected demand. A point where a commodity might get an unexpected demand has increased. There is that rise in the demand. Then it means that commodity will be available. Number five, it ensures continuous production. That means if it is a company or a firm that is dealing with the production of a certain commodity, for example, flour, and they have maize in the store, in the warehouse, then it means that there is the continuous production of the flour. Then, preparation of goods for sale. Now, when these goods are in the store, when these goods are in the warehousing, there is the branding that takes place. There is the packing that takes place. There is the labeling that takes place. So you get, during that process, when goods are in the warehouse, it is time for them to prepare goods for sale. Number seven, enables owner to look for markets. Yes, the commodity it is there in the warehouse, so I can just go out, just get the market where the goods are in the warehouse, and then come get with my buyer and I get the commodity and I don't pay for it or I don't take it to my premises. Number eight, goods can be improved in quality. This is the processing that takes place in that warehousing. Number nine, encourages specialization. Number 10, buyers can inspect goods. You can inspect goods. Assignment. I write four ways in which warehouse is useful to the trader. Reference book, KRB 2011, Invert and Secondary Business Student, Book 2, third edition. If at all you want to contact us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook and through the Twitter. Stay tuned to Edin TV. Thank you.